A horror movie for introverts. NC Fever, we follow a marine biology student. She is being forced to go on this vessel for like a week to do this scientific research. But while they're out in the deep Atlantic, they come across some creature that gives them all this sort of parasite, and now they're all sort of having to fight for their lives. Now, Sea Fever is an aquatic horror film that I was really looking forward to because, well, it's an aquatic horror film, and I love aquatic horror films, and I also really love movies that take place mostly entirely in one location. So this movie definitely looked like something that would be right up my alley. And while unfortunately I missed this movie at Fantastic Fest about 4 or 5 months ago, so I was happy to be able to watch this movie during isolation, during the pandemic. And ladies and gentlemen, I have to say, I'm actually glad I missed this movie during its festival run, because I think watching this movie during the pandemic added an extra layer of fear. Where Sea Fever really shines is how relevant it all feels. I think I honestly would have taken that subplot for granted if I saw it 4 or 5 months ago, because that added so much fear to the movie. And I think that the performances are fantastic, but it's the leading lady, played by Hermione Cornfield, who really excels in this movie. She's a fantastic, unique sort of leading role. And watching her as very much an introvert come out of her shell and take charge and, you know, figure out what they need to do, because she knows that she is the most smartest person on this vessel. As for the horror, I really, really loved a lot of the horror set pieces and the tension that this movie provides. You can look at that plot synopsis and say, yes, this is Alien and The Thing. And it very much is Alien and The Thing, but on a boat. But I, with that extra level of scientists who are actually smart, and unfortunately their wisdom is what in a sense is bringing fear to them, because they know how deadly this parasite is, and they are seeing the repercussions of it, that fear in a sense is making them fearful of what to do. And I really like that. Didn't expect this movie to be one of those gory films, but I really welcomed it, and I like the visceral that the gore sort of provided for the film, and I thought it was extremely tense. And also the movie is extremely claustrophobic. I mean, we are on this vessel, and they do a fantastic job at making you feel isolated and contained, and that you have nowhere else to run. And I thought that really added a lot to the movie. Overall, Sea Fever is a smart, intelligent, aquatic horror film that's very much in the veins of Alien and The Thing, but on a boat. There's some fantastic gory effects in this movie. There's some great horror set pieces. I think the lead performance from Hermione Cornfield is fantastic, and it earns an extra layer of fear for how relevant and how many similarities that you will see in this movie due to the pandemic of the times that we are living in right now. As the score goes, I'm going to give Sea Fever a 3.5 out of 5. So you guys, there you have it. That was my review for Sea Fever. If you saw this movie, make sure to let me know in the comment section below. And also let me know, how are you guys holding up during this pandemic? I hope you guys are doing good. I love you guys. And until next time, I'm the Slasher Movier, and you guys have just been slashed.